So we'll be discussing the same research topic that I explained to you in the previous video. What I'm going to do is to take you through a step-by-step journey of understanding how to use SPSS, and I'll make sure that these files reach you so that you can practice on them and learn the steps that I have taught you and practice them properly, so that when it comes to your own data analysis, you will have a much better idea of properly analyzing your data and coming up with the right interpretation for the results that you get. So let's move ahead. In the previous video, I explained to you the process of checking the reliability of your questionnaire. Now let's move ahead and conduct some more analysis on your data. So as I told you that I have developed a questionnaire, I actually adopted a questionnaire about this anticipated regret, risk aversion and marketing strategies impact on the student's buying behavior, which is the dependent variable, whereas these three are the independent variables. Based on this questionnaire, we have filled the entire SPSS file and we are trying to analyze it. These are the responses that were gathered from 300 participants. So it is important when you start your analysis process, what you do is you go ahead and properly try to come up with certain important tables and figures. Before that, I want to just show you the theoretical framework or the research framework. In this case, we have three independent variables, as I explained to you, and they are being checked against the dependent variable, that is buying behavior of university students. And you are trying to assess whether this would be a good relationship or not. The reliability statistics over here says that for 19 questions, the reliability was 0.786, which is quite high, which shows that the questionnaire was proper and credible. So this is good enough information that lets us move ahead and try to analyze the data further. So what I'll be doing is to tell you how to get these graphs. Basically, what you can do is you can get such tables from SPSS that tell you the exact percentages or frequencies of your data set, and you can probably make better graphs because SPSS does not provide you such pretty graphs with their software. So you might have to develop them by yourself. So let's come to the SPSS file and see how we can generate this frequency table for gender. So when you come to the analyze section, descriptive and frequencies, over here we can put age and gender just to get a general idea about the figures, and we can probably see if we want some bar charts for this data and select percentages over here. They will give us some random odd looking graphs, but that's not an issue. We'll get tables as well with the information that we need, and when we press OK, so here is how we are going to get the charts for the age and gender. So according to this, for gender it is saying that there are 64% part of the participants were male, while 36 were female, which completes our 100% data set. That was the 300 members. So 191 were male and 109 were female, total comprising of 300 participants. And if you see this bar chart, so for gender, this is the kind of chart that you'll get. So a better idea would be to avoid that and just copy this table, and based on this valid percentage of 64 and 36, you can make your own pie chart with the help of Word. So you can add labels, you can increase the size and edit it as well while you're at it. Furthermore, we can see that the age section is comprising of 20 to 25 years old were 37%, 26 to 30 years old were 54%, 31 to 35 years old were 9%. So that is also visible over here in this chart. People from higher age group were not because probably this is university students that are youngsters, and this age group might not be appropriate. So again, I've taken this main table and developed my own chart over here that looks much better. So another step that is very crucial for you is to make sure that what you are doing is and that you analyze your data for checking its normality. For the sake of normality, what we do is we go to analyze, we go for descriptives, and then we click this descriptives option. Over here, what we do is we select, like from age, it is already selected. I'll just go over to the last question, and from the first question, I'll press shift, and towards the last one, I'll just take the scale question portions, and then go for options and click these things like the mean of the data, what was the central tendency or the mean value, what was the standard deviation, how much did it deviate from the mean, the minimum maximum value, and I'll also select kurtosis and skewness that are also used for normality checking, and they are very helpful as well. So we click continue and we then press OK. And this is the table that we get for checking the normality of our data. So this is the first column represents, these are all the questions that were taken in that questionnaire that were given to the participants. There were 300 total participants. So again, all 300 have filled these questionnaires. Basically, when you send in the questionnaires, probably you get some problems with your questionnaire. Some people might not fill it properly, some might not understand it. So it's a better idea to just give away like 400 questionnaires in this case, and then probably remove those that have missing values, that have not been completed properly and are not submitted back to you in the time duration that you need them. So just to be on the safe side, I sent out a lot of questionnaires and just received around 300 that were authentic and properly filled. So I just used them for my analysis. Again, this is showing the minimum value. Since I showed you in the questionnaire, the minimum value was starting from strongly disagree, and then it reached out to strongly agree, which was on scale 5. So this is the minimum and maximum values. Again, this table helps you to make sure that the data has no issues. Generally speaking, like you have not missed out something, or you have not entered something that is overstating your data or causing any problems. Again, you have to make sure that the mean values should be within the range of 1 to 5. They should not exceed anything, because that would show that there is some suspicious thing or mysterious thing that is going on in your data. Maybe you have entered some number wrong, or you have made a mistake while you were manually typing the data. So make sure that these values are within the range, and they would highlight that the questionnaires were filled properly. Again, the standard deviation shows you how much deviation was there from the mean. So a higher value would indicate more deviation on that particular question. A lower value would indicate less deviation. Skewness tells you about the movement of the data, whether it was moving towards the right side of the graph or towards the left side of the graph. We want it to be within the range of minus 2 to plus 2. And in this case, our data is lying within the range of minus 2 and plus 2. Similarly, for kurtosis, it checks the height of the data. It should again not be beyond minus 2 and plus 2 range that is given for normality. So this is a very crucial table that helps you analyze your data. Over here, I have put this table, and you can just edit it according to your needs. You can increase the size, you can like improve it the way it looks depending on your needs again, and just format it according to your paper. All the questionnaire questions are present over here, and you have all the data that is related to the particular questionnaire. So it's quite interesting the way things are over here, and probably this is a good way to understand the figures. So I have interpreted it as well, like 300 participants completed the data, the skewness and kurtosis should range from minus 2 and should be within plus 2 and not exceeding it. So mean and standard deviation are used for checking the normality of the data. So these are all the steps. This is important as it helps you to understand the flow of your data overall, and lets you check it from time to time to make sure that everything is going perfectly as you want it to go, and there are no problems overall in your overall data. So I hope this video helped you understand how descriptive analysis works, and the way you can use graphs and charts to enhance your research paper and to make sure that you are getting a good grade in your final projects. So these are the basic steps that you need to understand, and actually research process is quite complicated. You can go about it through several different techniques, but According to me, the simpler the topic is, the better you understand it, and you within your grasp, you can just complete it within the time frame that is given to you, and just do something good for the society. So that's the whole purpose of research, probably, to help out someone in need and to find something that is valuable. So you do not want to complicate it too much and cause trouble for other people by using inappropriate techniques that you yourself do not understand and cannot interpret properly. So thank you so much for now. I'll be seeing you in another video. Take care. Thank you.